It's Fran. Again, in the lab, although you probably don't recognize this particular corner. This is the back part of the lab that I kind of intended originally to be like an area to shoot some projects on these desks, but soon after I moved in, they became overwhelmed with stuff and have been so for the last year until I just cleaned it up. So yeah, this is the other part of the lab. Welcome. But the reason I'm making this video is because I actually had a project on this table to do for a few weeks, and it's no longer here. I had to move it out of the shop because I had a really bizarre incident over the weekend. For the past few weeks, I've been doing the prep work to do a video about my old WEM tape delay, and I had it added in a box in storage for, you know, 10 years or so, and I pulled it out a couple months ago and sat it on the table here, intending to do a video on it. And like about, you know, 6 weeks ago or eight weeks ago, I just started to notice a smell in the lab when I'd come back here, smell of like modeling clay, like plasticine, you know, that very distinctive sort of clay, modeling clay smell, which is the plasticizer that makes plasticine, you know, it's basically plastic with a plasticizer in it, and the smell that it gives off is the plasticizer. It smelled like that, and the days went by and the weeks went by, it just got stronger and stronger, and I just couldn't stand it anymore. So I took the WEM and I stuck it in a plastic garbage bag, and the plasticine smell went away, and I went about my business. But over the weekend, I went to retrieve the tape machine out of the bag to start working on it, and I got hit in the face with this huge, like, acid vapor, just boom, and in the, you know, fraction of a second that it got into my nostrils, I instantly sort of automatically just exhaled and stepped back, and but it burned my nose, and I had to spend the evening irrigating my nostrils and putting my head over a steaming bowl to, you know, breathe in steam vapor to, you know, re-moisturize my sinuses and such. It was very distressing, especially since Philly's in lockdown and you can't go to emergency room or anything, and it was very, you know, unexpected and distressing incident. And I put the tape machine into a box and then transported it out the next day, took it over to the factory, very briefly went over there to drop it off and let it outgas over there, and because I figured putting it in the plastic was a bad move. Whatever it was outgassing, it caused a kind of a chemical reaction, and you know, I got not just the plastic plasticine smell, but the acidic vapor. And so this has caused me much distress because, as you can see, my shop is all stuff. It's like piled up with stuff. All these bins have parts in them and everything, and I've become very wary of the disintegration of a lot of these materials, the unpredictability of the disintegration of plastics and the kinds of chemicals that they outgas. I've got a Pilot Hi-Fi that I used to have in my office. I restored it a few years ago, and I was, you know, it's a really great hi-fi with a three-speed turntable and everything. I really love it, but it too outgasses when I run it. After I run the Pilot for maybe half an hour, 45 minutes, it starts to exude the smell of licorice, which is very perplexing because I haven't been able to figure out exactly what is outgassing. I mean, I recapped it and everything. It's solid state. You know, it's from the late 60s, and I have no clue what exactly is making the smell or what's getting warm or what kind of chemical it could be outgassing. But I stopped using it just because I didn't like being overwhelmed by the smell of licorice. And, you know, all these crates in the storage, you know, the in the vault, I got about 350 crates in there. Crates just like these that I have here in the lab, and but I've got a lot more of them over there, and they are chock full of parts and stuff. And out of convenience, because of the eviction, I had to, you know, find a way to move things. And I've, you know, for decades I had put things in cardboard boxes, but with the, you know, the constant moving and everything and having to move everything to storage very quickly, I just went with bins, like plastic lidded bins. And so all my stuff, even like the antique radios and stuff, are all in crates with lids on them and stacked up, you know, on top of each other, because it's all, you know, the vault is like one like big space, so I've got like the large crates are like stacked on top of one another with stuff in them, and it's like, you know, now I'm worried that having crated everything with good intentions, because the idea was to keep moisture out and to keep vermin out in storage and everything, but now with this incident with the WHIM, I'm worried that I'm keeping outgassing chemicals in, and then you get, you know, these sorts of situations where you get one thing that's outgassing a chemical, and then that reacts with everything else. Now I'm stuck with the idea of having to totally redo the vault and find a way to, like, you know, either drill holes in the crates and stuff to you know, vent them out, to allow them to, you know, vent and outgas and such, and things I didn't even consider that I'd have to do. And the other thing that happened over the past week, just to add to the distress about stuff, was I found out from a commenter who commented on a video that I made some time ago about shellac records, that the acetates that I have, because I talked about the acetates, and it turns out that the acetates that I have, the one-offs, you know, like original recordings from the 50s and the 40s, are not actually acetate. They call them acetates, but they're actually nitrocellulose lacquered discs, so they're actually nitro. Took me by surprise, and I actually had to take an inventory, and I had like five of those discs that now I want to get out of the lab. You know, it's like I don't want to have them like in the lab, you know, nitro lacquer discs that are, you know, 80 years old. I just, it's like, but what do you do with them? It's like, you know, I don't know anyone who will take them or can hold on to them or store them. I don't want to destroy them, but I, you know, someone else should be taking care of them instead of me. So, you know, now I'm going through my mind and doing a mental inventory of the things that I either have to move or get rid of or whatever, but it's just, it's really tough. You know, when you're a curator of very old things, and these old plastics and materials, they disintegrate in very unpredictable ways, and it's disheartening. And, you know, I put it to you, if anyone out there, any of you are like experts at like preservation of some of these things, if you have any good advice for what I should do about the stuff in storage. Climate control is, you know, going to be a big thing, so, you know, it should keep things cool and everything, but, you know, as I explained in my live feed, you know, the vault, unfortunately, the climate-controlled storage, there really isn't any good climate-controlled storage in Philadelphia. It's all like marginally climate-controlled. I pay for climate-controlled storage, but in the summertime it gets up to like 85 degrees in there, and in the wintertime it gets down to like, you know, 40 degrees. And so, you know, they run the thermostat like absolute minimum, and they run the air conditioning absolute minimum. And I've complained, and they're like, well, that's you know. It's not climate, even though you pay for climate control. It's like, oh, we don't call it climate control, we call it climate. These are the climate floors. I said, that's not grammatically correct. You can't say it's a climate floor. That doesn't make any sense. And I said, well, they just took the word control out of it, so that they're not liable for claiming to be climate controlled, even though when you sign on it on the paper, it says you're paying for climate control. But then it's a huge thing. It's so... In Philly, I can't get like real like air-conditioned climate control storage. It just doesn't exist. They're all kind of the same, pulling the same schemes. So yeah, it's a big problem. You know, I've been all over. Actually, the stuff that's in the vault, I've actually moved it from two other storage places in the last 5 years that had even worse problems. I had really good climate control storage about, you know, 3 years ago. And it was, you know, they kept like 75 degrees even in the middle of the summertime. They kept a very low humidity. It was great, you know, that particular storage facility, they lost their lease because they didn't own the building. And they got kicked out of the building. And I had like 3 weeks' notice to vacate. And so I ended up in the place I am now. And I've shopped around, and there's really no other alternative. So I'm just kind of stuck. But. So, my video on the tape echo is, I don't know when I'm going to do it. I don't know when I can bring it back. I've got to kind of let it outgas and see if it stops stinking. I've had stuff, vinyl and such that would outgas for periods of time and then stop outgassing and just for whatever reason stop stinking. But we'll just have to see. But it was very distressing, and it's... got me wondering what else is going to go wrong, you know, as all this stuff ages. And, But if you have any advice for what I should do on any of this stuff, leave a comment, and yeah, we'll just have to get back to the stuff. All right, that's it. That's it for this one. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching, even though this, you know, I really didn't show you anything in this one. Thanks, and thanks to all of the patrons on the Patreon that, you know, keep the lab going. If it weren't for the patrons, I wouldn't even have any of this. You know, I wouldn't have that storage and everything, so thank you very much, everyone who supports the lab on Patreon. All right, I'll be back here. Well, I don't know if I'll be here. I might be over there or over there. I got all these choices now that I've cleaned up the lab, so, but I'll be back real soon. At the bench again.